I first picked up a violin bow out of love. Not love for the instrument or even for music, but for my teacher. Diana Mills, back in my hometown in Minnesota, was my sister's teacher first, and her kind voice and gentle hand led my fingers to the strings as well. Every week I worked ahead in my assignments just to see her face light up. Giving her joy gave me joy. At 9 years old, my greatest joy in playing music was pleasing someone I loved. I don't think we ever outgrow this joy, yet I think we come to treat it as childish or even wrong. People-pleasing, we call it, and in its twisted form, that's what it can become. A constant chasing for approval, a longing for love and acceptance in the wrong place. We like to believe the story that we're all self-sufficient, that we don't need others' love, their acceptance, because our belief in ourselves is all that matters. This is a lie, a way of seeing a problem and putting forth the wrong solution. When a man becomes an island, he is merely a volcano that none but the cold sea dare approach. Yet hunting for deep, full, perfect love in other people fails too. Every human unfailingly fails, and a foundation built from them will break, given more than a moment. So what now? Do we sequester ourselves with God alone, far from the hurt that comes with other people? He who has God and everything else has no more than he who has God only, right? Yet even God said it was not good for man to be alone when Adam had God himself before his eyes. God is not insufficient, yet he didn't build us to be with him alone. Perhaps the answer lies in between, in the place where God approves, accepts, and loves, and his people say amen. Where we make music to give joy to God and man, our souls resting in the unmoving, dynamic love of God. Where, being ever safe in God's arms, we willingly risk danger by loving those whom he also loves. Perhaps with a song, perhaps with a bow, perhaps with a piano and songs others have sung. Many of the songs I'm playing today are secular, but no piece of beauty, whether music or anything else, can help praising its ultimate maker. I hope they give you joy, and more than that, I hope they draw you close in spirit to the God who loves this music most. This first piece, Theme of Mitsuha by Yojiro Noda, is from the soundtrack of the movie Your Name. Its notes seem to me to carry threads of a theme woven throughout the story, the silent yet desperate longing to be with someone you love. I wonder if you can hear it too. This next piece is a classical one, Sonatina No. 1 by Mazio Clementi. Classical tends to get a bad rap as something only nerdy prodigies like, but that's not true at all. Clementi was a classic case of a child prodigy, but he was human like the rest of us, and that shines through in his music if you're willing to see past the seemingly constrained style. In reality, classical music often reflects a truth so often forgotten, that freedom is found within boundaries. This sonatina is strictly bound to a rhythm, yet its notes are free. So too are we freest within the limits of our God. In classical music, all music is constrained by some boundary. If it weren't, it wouldn't be music. This piece, Jürgen's Tune by Andrew Peterson, is also very rhythmic, but it holds the same wild, sea-like freedom as the fictional dragon for whom it is named, Jürgen, the former king of the dragons in the riveting Wing Feather Saga.
Thank you.
whispers about God. Some sings his name clearly, reaching deep into the soul with carefully crafted words. This next song is one that's brought me to tears on multiple occasions. If you go to my church, you may remember it from a few weeks ago. It's also by Andrew Peterson, and it was written for his daughter as she struggled through a period of self-loathing. As he played it for her for the first time, however, Andrew mentioned this sense coming over him, this whisper, as if God was telling him, "Andrew, listen to the way a father loves his child." Somehow. Have you ever walked in the woods in the moonlight or watched firelight dance against the branches on the forest edge? It's ethereal, haunting, mystical. There's something hidden in those shadows as they dance across the ground. They move in an erratic rhythm as if keeping their secrets just out of arm's reach. But what if we could meet the shadows in truth, see their dance as it is when we're not watching? This next piece I wrote myself and I named it after this impression. You'll have to judge if I captured it or not.
Thank you.
In my judgment, my next piece is the most musically beautiful of them all, My Life by Masaru Yokoyama. From the soundtrack of Your Lie in April, it captures the subtle essence of regret pouring from an aftermath of the carefully built lie, and the tender, sorrowful love that brings healing if we're willing to let it. To a close, so I'll leave you with a song that, though the simplest to play of them all, is one of the most beautifully heartbreaking. Andrew Peterson wrote this one as well for the Wing Feather Saga, and like theme of Mitsuha, its soul lies in the lengths a person is willing to go to be with their beloved. Thank you for joining me today, and for celebrating the gift God gave us in music along with me. And though my heart my love. I loved you best. Rejoice, my love, and call me blessed. In death, my love, I loved you.